There will be a halftime intermission about 45 minutes in, so that any of you can get up and stretch your legs, go to the restroom, whatever you would like to do, and then we'll have some more. So we're not going to have introductions of everyone tonight. We're just going to begin. There will be introductions later. So, Irena, it's all yours.
Oh, next piece we are going to perform is Moldau by Smetana with Svetlana. Thank you.
Thank you.
present our wonderful volunteers who are working really, really hard to make lives of people better overseas. And then I would like to ask Jeff Power to come for this little Ukrainian poem, which is a very, very special piece. So this is a melody by Miroslav Skoryk.
Get great amount of medical and military supplies. Surprisingly, we got so much support, not just from our community, but from other states, other communities. In the beginning, we faced a lot of challenges with logistics and shipment delays, and big shipping companies. Plus, we were not sure where exactly the help will be sent. So the time was the biggest issue for us, so we decided to deliver everything ourselves. At first, there were 15 luggage bags per person, and now here we are with 39 to 49 pieces of luggage per person. I personally fly to Poland. Then from there, we deliver it to Ukraine. We are not using any third parties and make sure soldiers get everything directly. While big organizations use at least 20% for operational expenses, we use 100% of collected money to buy supplies. Thanks to our fellow volunteers from Ukraine, who've been helping since 2014, we get we're getting useful information regarding specific needs of our soldiers. With their support, we can use all donated money wisely without overpaying. We pack everything at my place, handle all the paperwork for logistics, deal with tremendous amount of phone calls, research. Our husbands help us with packing and transporting everything as well. I get questions from people all the time, how can you possibly handle it? And my answer is simple, if we can do it, anyone can do it. At the moment, we are in the process of registering for a nonprofit organization, but meanwhile, please consider donating to our Zelle, Venmo, PayPal. We'll be more than happy to give you all the information or answer all the questions you might have. Again, my name is Victoria Malnik. This is Marina and Diana. This is our team. Thank you so much. Glory to Ukraine, Slava Ukraine.
We do get a lot of questions, like Victoria mentioned, what can I do? And I have an answer your summer steeple have helped us so tremendously that I cannot even express myself. So it's not a secret that it's not the donations from big companies that made a huge impact or a big difference. It's people, simple people who help, who are willing to give up almost the last penny they have in their pocket in order to save a life or to help homeless or even to, you know, offer a hand to your friend who's in need. So saying that, I want to say that many people ask, but I don't have much to offer. Every dollar counts, every penny counts, and it goes directly towards the cause. So it's, you know, those pennies, those dollars, it's what ends up, adds up, it makes a big, big difference. You know, was that, like Mariana said, the best events that have been happening in Ukraine, especially events that happened yesterday, was public execution of people, soldiers who were just pretending, protecting and defending their homeland, just shocked us. Shocked us even more, I can't say even more, but shocked us so, so greatly that, again, today in the morning I woke up and I just told to myself, I have to do it. I have to speak, I have to ask people for help. But we never done it before. It's all new to us also. And you know, like Victoria said, we do fly a lot. We fly often, it goes directly to the front lines. You know, and it's only because of how the people of the communities, like your community, like our community in Rockland County, we were able, so far, we were able to deliver to Ukraine successfully near 15,000 of humanitarian aid that includes such a critical medical supplies, tactical gear, tactical gear, and so, so many, many more. You know, with help of people like you, help of people in different communities, we really hope to help those desperate people in need, our Ukrainians, and hopefully very, very soon stop Russian aggression that's so ruthlessly happening in Ukraine. Thank you. Glory to Ukraine.
Talk to about why it's so important that you contribute to this cause of this time, whatever it is that you can. And I would like you to consider this the fifth speech.
Thank you.
great. Found everyone, and then Gocha is going to perform a traditional Georgian song and song.
Thank you. Thank you.
two pieces.
Thank you. The crows and the ravens will be flying and scattering our bones across the country. Thousands of buildings have been burned, bombed. The smoldering ashes are still, you can see them for miles. Thousands of unmarked graves lying there with no marks. And the ones buried there stretch out their arms in the quiet still of the night and look up to God with their eyes wide open and say to God, do you not hear our blood-curdling cries of despair? And that is what's happening in Ukraine today. And this piece, I will tell you what it's about, because it's a short piece. It's about a cousin going off to war, and he's saying farewell to his beloved. And he's going on that horse, and he's riding through wintry fields, and then through the spring, and through the fall, and through the autumn. And all he cares about is that horse will carry him back to his beloved one more time.
Both Ukrainian and Russian, which is fluent in.
She also created really beautiful pins. She designed it by herself, and I'm wearing it tonight, and they're outside in the little box. And she sent them here, and please take a look at them, they're very lovely. A Croatian woman, whom I hardly knew, who drove 10 hours to Slovenia to pick my mom and my uncle from the bus that they were for 3 days in. A few days earlier, when I was at work, accompanying the choir, early in the morning, I received a message that one of the buses in the caravan of the cars, where my mom and my uncle was, where it was shelled. And they were cooped up in the bus for 30 hours without any permission to leave. My mom's picture that came through with their smiling faces a few minutes after this message, saying, "We are okay." At the very next moment, my Scarsdale High School choir, whom I accompanied, singing a prayer for Ukraine that they learned just for me as a surprise and as a support. A person, a random person, I had never met this person, and he just came to the concert, to our concert with Gocha at Carnegie Hall, and he wrote a check for $70,000 to support the shelter that has been purchased several weeks ago and already hosted 12 families with the legal, psychological help, and the kids are celebrating their birthdays there. An 8-month pregnant woman who, along with her 3-year-old child, was driving from eastern part of Ukraine, Ukrainian Kharkiv, throughout the country through block stops for days to Poland to give birth to her second child in Warsaw. She is now in safety here in Westchester with her 2 children. A Scarsdale girl whom I never met. She donated 11 boxes of the coolest stuff that she ordered for her bat mitzvah, and she donated to Ukrainian orphanage. 47 interns at Greenberg Town Hall were planning on collecting items for Ukraine after my lecture was done this past Tuesday. They have made this decision. A constant offers of the housing from Westchester residents toward Ukrainian refugees, working day and night on distributing people into different houses and apartments while collaborating with Jewish Immigration Coalition of Westchester, which is providing them with pro bono, legal, psychological, and also with monetary assistance. Next week, I'm departing to Austria, for Austria, to run my annual summer festival, Music in the Alps. And I'm absolutely humbled to meet 18 Ukrainian musicians without homes, scattered around Europe, scared of not knowing what the future brings, but so full of energy, ambitions, respect, and kindness. Their stay during my festival, their performances, and masterclasses are supported by you. Thank you. Now, your 52 boxes that have been collected here is a separate story. If you who are sitting here were part of the collection project, you can note to yourself somewhere in your diary, "I saved lives." This is true. Your contribution was immeasurable. The boxes arrived to Ukraine a week ago and were distributed within centers. This is a message from the volunteer, Ludmila Chichuk. By the way, she's a pianist, but she's not practicing right now. She's busy saving the country. We are incredibly grateful to Norman, Father Mike, and your community for your enormous help. It was beyond imaginable to unload those boxes and realizing how much time, thought, energy, kindness were put there. The chicken soup was the hit of the season. And one of the tourniquets stayed alive, and one of the limbs of the boy who unfortunately picked up a gadget from the ground was a stone mold in it. A wonderful musician and a friend, Bob Arthurs, an absolutely fantastic jazz trumpeter, recorded Ukrainian songs in a beautiful jazz arrangement of his own. I produced this CD 5 years ago, which got so many fantastic reviews on different platforms, and it is available outside. Bob is also has also composed a piece, this is number 11, it was a surprise for me, it was called Blues for Ukraine. And Bob specially brought a box of his CDs to contribute as his contribution, as he wasn't available tonight. I have given a live interview to Ukrainian radio, morning edition. It means it was 1:30 at night here. And they were talking about you, your collection, your 52 boxes, about Norman, his significant book, Gaps and Bridges, about Father Mike, Ina, and everyone who was part of this beautiful project. So it's July 30th, and it feels like it started, the war started yesterday. It means a lot to me to see more interest and more eagerness to be part of help. Always. Yet especially this summer, do I wake up with the words of gratitude that my family is safe, but also with the prayer to do more and more to bring something positive into this world by making people's lives better with help of so many of you. And here, of course, I'm mentioning again Norman, Father Mark, Linda, Janet from the church office, everybody, thank you so much for having us here. Our wonderful places to eat, the restaurants who contributed tonight, a beautiful part of the process. Thank you so much for our volunteers who, from the first source, were telling you what they were doing or what's going on. And the last, but not the least, my incredibly talented, loyal friends whom I share a lot with. So I would like you to come here, please. Svetlana, Stefan, Jeffrey, and Gocha. Thank you, Gocha. Come here. Yes. You guys have given me so much talent, so much time, so much energy, so much love. And I'm not sure I will be able to pay back anyhow in this life. And every note with you, every rest with you is filled with meaning. And it sits beautifully and deeply in my heart forever. Thank you so much. And on our behalf, I would like to thank you for displaying such a beautiful unity while being here and supporting people, women, children, elderly who fled the war, who have suffered losses of their homes and loved ones, and those who are getting up from their knees to rebuild their lives and hopes.
It's very appropriate that the last word will be a word that we all need to remember. easy to say when we're feeling good, but it is equally important to say this word when we're not feeling so good, when things don't seem to be that positive. That word is Alleluia.